sure that by the time we finish for ministry there for 2 weeks, there must be a church out there. That's how we spread. That's how anywhere God wants us to go, we go out there and we start a church. And again, God also helps us to train people. I like the emphasis you made here that everyone here is a minister. That's what we teach in our church. I mean, we are one of the first churches in Nigeria to ordain women and to tell them women can preach the gospel. My wife preaches better than me. He understands the Bible. He reads more. He prays more. And no, it's true. So I don't see why. I mean, the prophecy that established our ministry came from her. She wasn't my wife. Then we are all students in this campus. You know what? If she wasn't listening to God and got that word of God, there wouldn't be CRM today. And so how can I now come and say that somebody that God has used so might be that way? She's not qualified to be a pastor or be a reverend or whatever we call them. All right, so we encourage everybody in our ministry, old and young. It's not been easy. Don't think what I'm going to say is very easy. Because an average person doesn't believe that God could use him. But we keep emphasizing that. We keep insisting on that. We keep in our foundation class, we the last thing everybody does is spiritual gift analysis. And after spiritual gift analysis, you must choose a function to play in the church. Either you are in the choir, or you are in the orchard, or you are in the children ministry, or in the youth ministry, or you are... There must be something. We have plenty of them. There must be something that will keep you busy in the church. And in so way, by so doing, we keep encouraging people to get involved in the work of the ministry. And that gives us a large mass, a large number of people we could use. The only that can keep us is employment. If they're employed somewhere, it's difficult to pull them out. Okay? But as much as possible, we still have quite a number of people we can send from here to here to places to go and plant churches and things like that. And then again, because of that, every of our member, for instance, if any member of my ministry comes to Ireland today, either to work or to school, it's concluded he's going to plant a church. It's simple. It's concluded. He's going to plant a church.
That's right.
All right? Any, you see, our church is everywhere. That's how they plant it. Somebody goes out either to go to school or to go and do business. He becomes a missionary. Because there are the two things that define my ministry are two. One is missions. Another is revival. We live for only those two. If it is revival, you wake us up anytime we are involved. If it is missions, wake us anytime you are involved. In fact, my member, a pastor in my ministry, is the head of missionary movement in Nigeria today. I mean, all the other churches are subject to him. If I go to a meeting, he's my boss. We sit down and then, but he's my mission director. He's a movement for national initiative in Nigeria. He's a member, he's a pastor in my church. Because of our involvement in missions. So missions are important. All right, you must be involved in missions. Even if you are not going to plant churches, contribute whatever little money you have to advance the work of God's mission. We do 20 or 40 days fast every year. We usually start it somewhere in January and end 18th of February every year, either 40 days or 21 days. At the last day, the last Friday leading to the 18th of February of that year, we will have a night vigil in all my churches all over the world. And in that night vigil, we will take offering. Every couple we raise in that offering, we don't use it in our ministry. All of those money, we use it to support missions, to it to support other churches, to it to support, you know, people that are needful. And we raise a lot of money out of it. I mean, we raise a lot of money out of it. And sometimes we are tempted, this big money, I want to use to do our own work. No way. We must give out all of those to support what God is doing in other places. Okay, to encourage the work of God in other places. We don't spend a dime on it in our own ministry. We give it all out. Okay? Now, such are things God don't know. God likes that.
Yes.
So you keep investing in God's kingdom and advancing the work of the Lord. That's the only way. You ask whether some people break away. Plenty of them break away. The first people that broke away formed what they call Watchman, and it's because that happened in 1986. It's because we refused to leave the Catholic Church. They came to us and wanted us to leave the Catholic Church. But I said, God hasn't asked me to leave the Catholic Church. We actually left the Catholic Church in 1998. All right? I said, God didn't ask me to leave the Catholic Church. We want to remain here. We are biblical. We do anything that is not in the Bible without getting involved. And the Catholic people know it. The bishops know that. That we don't get involved. And so they dealt with us. When I mean dealing with us, they really dealt with us. Okay? But we didn't care. So Washman, because of that, left in 1986. Then following Washman, and Washman is a big ministry in Nigeria today. And I praise God for them. My joy that majority of their leaders were my disciples. Okay? And we are still in good faith. We are still friendly. And we see greet each other. I don't worry with people about that. I mean, I don't care. What's important is, let's all get to heaven. When we get there, God will sort this out for us.
That's right.
Then the second one that left is, they call themselves now Light Intercessors. It was led by one of our pastors in Port Harcourt. But eventually, God convicted him. He came back to our ministry, came back empty because they pushed him away from that church. He took away. And they pushed him away. So he began to hang somewhere. And things were difficult for him. He came back. I said, okay, what do I do for you now? He said, anything you want us to do, anything you want me to do, I will do. That he's sorry for what he did. I said, it's all right. Let's keep you. We welcome him back. We put him on salary and his wife. We rented a house for them. We took good care of them. He died 2 years ago. We buried him very well. And still keep his family, maintain his family, and pay their school fees up until today, and things like that. And then and that church he took away came back. The leaders came to me and said they want to come back. I said, good enough. No, you stay where you are and continue what you did, but we'll be in relationship. At least once a year, I will come and do program for you people. But just stay, and keep your identity and keep on going. It's better for us that way, so that the work of God will go on with little or no acrimony involved in it. So we have had that. And we have other smaller ones left. All right, and even some of them that live properly, we support them actually. Jubilee Assembly in Imo State, you know what? It was my choir leader, his deputy choir leader in Imo State, no worry. He came to me and said he wants to leave. I said, good enough. And of course, we left. We gave him money to rent property, and we are paying both his house rent and the church rent for a couple of years before he was able to stabilize. Now they have bought land and built their own property. But we supported them fully. To me, it's some work we are doing. I'm not in competition with anybody.
No.
Okay? It's the same work we are doing. If somebody comes to me and says he's good. In London here, my leader in London left. Ndo left. And I came to UK. I said, okay. I love Ndo. Ndo is my preferred leader of CRMU. I like the guy. But he wants to leave. And okay. He left. And but he thought I was going to be angry, I was going to quarrel with him. No, but that day we raised a lot of money for them. I mean, my people left the respondents, and we raised big money. And we gave him. And I appointed Kalade to take over from him. And I told Kalade, anytime you do a program, you must invite him to come and preach here. I said, Ndo, you are not leaving, you are opening another branch. When I come to UK, after preaching in CRM, if I have time, I come and preach in your home. That's the work of God is going on. You see, that's our attitude to that. We try as much as possible not to carry bitterness with anybody.
Yes.
Our heart is clean and perfect towards people.
Yes.
We don't quarrel with people. I mean, all my people, in fact, 2015, we had our World Congress. We invited all the people that ever left us. Say, all of you should come for new anointing, new impartation. They were all broken. They were all crying there, big men. I said, they didn't know I could do that. I said, what? Am I quarreling with you people? No. I don't worry, even though some of you didn't do well, some of you didn't behave well. But it doesn't matter, we are forgiving all those.
Right.
We are moving forward. Come and receive new anointing and new impartation for the work of the Lord.
Yeah.
And that has helped us a lot. God bless you.
Yeah. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Are you feeding very well?
Yes.
Are you enjoying the food?
Yes.
It's so sweet.
Yes.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Because of time, I have so many questions here, but we are going to continue in the evening.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
If you have other questions, please write. We are going to continue in the evening, and we want to keep to time. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
1 o'clock, we are going. So remember, I said they are going to anoint us. What are they going to anoint us on?
Yes.
Power. Praise the Lord. Okay, can we all quickly come? Let the children come first, the youth, and then, you know, just like that, so that, you know. And that power is not for playing. You know, it's not for you to play too much. The power, because the power is very evident. The power is for you to go and do exploits. You know? You are called to show forth the praises of him who have called you out of darkness into his marvelous light. Okay? So you are going to go out there with your breakdancing to win Christ. With your boxing to win Christ. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Are you ready?
Oh, yes.
Okay. Please, sir. Yeah. Praise the Lord. Oh, Rabba Shantala.
Receive the power of God in your life in the name of Jesus. Receive the power of God in your life in the name of Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Receive the power of God in your life in the name of Jesus. Receive the power of God in your life in the name of Jesus.
Glory to your name.
Receive the power of God in your life in the name
of Jesus. Oh, Lord. Glory to you. Oh Lord,
the youths, please.
Oh, for your name is great.
Thank you.
praise the Lord. It's not the basket is there. If you have your offering, if you have your tithe, you can put it in there as you're going. Praise the Lord. And the Lord will bless you. We are back here by the grace of God at 6. Please noise it around. Tell everyone to come. And you come yourself. Praise the Lord. Don't tell people to come and then you'll be missing. Tell everyone to come. And 6 we start. 6 we start because we have a lot that God has in store for us. Somebody shout hallelujah. And now may the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the sweet fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us now and forevermore. Amen. The Lord is our shepherd. We shall not want. He makes us to lie down in green pastures. He leads us beside the still waters. He restores our soul. He leads us to the path of righteousness for his name's sake. Yea, though we walk through the valley of shadow of death, we shall fear no evil. But thou art with us, thy rod and thy staff. Thou anointed our head with oil, our cup running over. Surely, your goodness and mercy follows us all the days of our life, and we dwell in the house of the Lord forever and ever. Amen. I am blessed. I have glory. I have honor. I have peace. I have joy. I have love. I have power. I have sound mind. I have favor. I have healing. I have thanksgiving. I will worship. I have life. I have abundance. I have faith. I am covered by the blood of Jesus. I have victory. I will recover. I will praise. I will be remembered. I will reign. I have fame. I will shine. I have fullness. I have obedience. I have distinction. I have promotion. I have fruitful. I have multiplication. I have replenishment. I have dominion. I have the fire of the Holy Ghost. I am justified. I am helpful. I am beautiful. I am majestic. I have laughter. I have guidance. I have strength. I have greatness. I have satisfaction. I will be carried on eagle's wings. I have wisdom. I have anointing. I have immunity. I have dreams. I have unity. I have completion. I will make history. I will see miracles. I have uncommon success. I will overflow. I will have it. The hand of the Lord is upon me. I will be restored. I have expectation. I will serve. Heavens will open for me. Doors will open for me. I will see new things. I shall experience sudden blessings. I will be comforted. I will enlarge. I will rise. I will be released. I have freedom. Showers of blessings are upon me. I have life. I will increase. And we shall subdue the earth. In Jesus' name. Amen. Prosperity and pleasure are ours. In Jesus' name. Amen. I am an ambassador. I am more than a conqueror. I have speed. I will finish well. I have self-control. I'm the temple of the living God. I'm God's battlers. I'm God's masterpiece. I'm the light of the world. I'm God's workmanship. I'm God's treasure. I'm God's juggernaut. In Jesus' name. Amen. I shall not die but live to declare the glory of God in the land of the living. In Jesus' name. Amen. We shall see evil no more. In Jesus' name. Amen. I will not go empty this year. In Jesus' name. Amen. Please, everyone that is here, if you can come. At the end of every service, please don't let me tell you. Just come. We'll take picture. To every day, we are putting up memory. And to this evening, we are having our jeans and t-shirts. You have to stay around to get your t-shirts. Praise the Lord. So you have to stay around to get your t-shirts. Praise the Lord. We are having our jeans and t-shirts for this evening. And everyone, every son and daughter, am I talking?
Yes.
Shh, Bobo and Ima, am I talking? Okay. Only one of us, eh? Okay. So please, let us wait and get our t-shirts before we go. And let it be colorful this evening as you wear your beautiful t-shirt and jeans. Amen. And it's, even if you have blazer, put on the blazer on top of the jeans to make it some kind of posh, you know? Some, you know, some putting class on it. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Okay, let's take the picture. Bring the chairs and men of God, come on. Hey,
Hello, do you? All the youth, please, we want to see you at a birthday. At a birthday. You have to go there. You know, you're our pastor. You pastor, go there.
Okay. Is it children first or is it
everyone?
Put your face up.
I'll get you. Just when everybody scared first before I take the picture. Everybody look towards this way.
I can see. Bishop Joseph. When you finish that, you use this one. No worries, take that one first.
Hello.
Well, who are the people that are outside? Pastor BC. Yeah, I like that song. That song is nice. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Just started.
I don't know the people.